Port-au-Prince is busy. It's constantly moving. And until you can actually pick up on the patterns and recognize what's going on, it seems incredibly disorganized. And at first, as somebody coming from a formalized economy like the US, you think, where is the system? And then you realize you're just the one that doesn't have the roadmap. In June, I launched a clean water business called Kouzin Dlo in Haitian Creole, or Community Chlorinators in English. And it's a direct sales company that trains women to sell liquid chlorine for household water treatment in their communities all throughout the country. First and foremost, Kouzin Dlo is about disease prevention. And then the second part, the mechanism by which we prevent disease, is by creating jobs. Some of our first funding was from the Tisch College at Tufts University. After that, the Archimedes Project, our parent organization, helped us to do a crowdfunding campaign that we were successful with, and that kind of rounded out our summer funding for the pilot and to get us into the fall.
Legitimately one of the most impressive young people, or actually people, full stop, period, end of sentence, that I've ever met. She's going to be running Community Chlorinators in Haiti.
I'm trained as a scientist. I studied microbes, specifically I studied cholera, and trying to understand how it's capable of transmitting so rapidly in populations. But when your desire, as was mine, as is mine, is to actually lower disease burden and to keep people, especially young children, from dying from diarrhea, science is not the right way to go because we already have the solution. It's all about clean water access, something that we've been able to fix since the late 1800s. That just seems completely unacceptable to me. It's not about using more force for this really difficult problem. It's about local buy-in. It's about business models, it's about partnerships, it's about finding funding, it's about bringing them together and using them as leverage to solve this problem.
In order for Kouzin Dlo to launch in a community, we first start by building a partnership. So we'll have some conversations. What organizations have come in before? Where do people get water? What is the sanitation situation? Have you been experiencing cholera? Is diarrhea prevalent? And then after the site visit, along with our partner, we recruit a few women to come and to be trained as managers.
Depuis après choléra, t'es venu parler. T'es grand pile monde dans zone là, t'es gué maladie choléra. Mais qui ça te bat au choléra? C'est de l'eau et non de l'eau, je n'ai avec non fatra. Pour nous aller maintenant de l'eau traitée à l'hiver important dans la zone là.
Tous les deux intéressés, parce que ni comment pour traiter de l'eau, ça intéresse. Ni pour faire business, ni comment pour faire un business, c'est très intéressant.
What's really cool about the product is its simplicity. It's not a filter with multiple steps. One capful of the same bottle that holds the chlorine in it goes into a 5-gallon bucket. I love working with Haitians. The ingenuity and the creativity and just the overall capacity to fix problems, to put the different resources together in a way that makes it work. In Haiti, you make things work.
Ça qui vraiment motive me dans Kouzin Dlo, c'est lorsque moi-même, moi viens devenir un pionnier, moi viens devenir une tête dans les affaires de traiter le monde, et moi c'est un agent santé, moi profiter de l'agent santé avec Kouzin Dlo, pour me faire message la passer puis bien.
One of the ways that our product markets itself is actually in giving out a sample of the water treated with the chlorine, because people are constantly amazed by the taste. But we really hold firm to this is a product that you buy, because we want the message about Kouzin Dlo to be this is something that someone in my community is actually making money by participating in this. The important thing is that we function as a business. So I make decisions about what buckets to use, what materials to use, how much to pay the different people working for us as a business would. I think that that really has allowed me from day one to look at the question of sustainability. In the aid model, you create the jobs for that person handing it out while the money lasts. Sustainability in a business means, are the numbers actually going to end up at the end of the day? Is this going to continue going and continue supplying the product to the customer? When I graduated from Tufts, I really felt like, okay, I took all of these courses and now I'm starting this business with the tools that I learned in the classroom. I couldn't wait to get back to Haiti and to actually see how it worked on the ground. But at the end of the day, I went back to feeling over my head and not knowing if I could do it. So it was definitely a bit of a roller coaster. Being here, the 5 months that I've been here, has gone exactly as I wanted it to, because my expectation was to learn. My expectation was that the idea that I originally came down with was going to be significantly revised. My dream for Kouzin Dlo is that we would really prove that this works, right? That we would be successful as a business, but more importantly, this would be a lesson learned in how you can get a life-saving technology into the hands of the people that need it.